I'm Dane.
My name is Jeanette. From the look on your face, you're hoping he's not related, right? Is it so wrong? Help.
Are you all right? I like your PJs. I heard a crash. Are you all right? I think I'm all right. I was carrying my clothes down to wash, didn't see where I was going, and I fell. She helped me up. Good night, then. Would you like me to help you with... It's all right. Don't you have a friend to get back to? I do. Well... Good night. Good night. Come up here. I want someone to talk to. I'm sorry I laughed when I found you like that last night. That's okay, I probably did look funny. You arrived quickly. I thought something happened to my grandma. Well, she was fine. Did you get really injured? No, I got maybe a few bruises, but it's fine, it just startled me. That's good, I mean, it's good that you didn't get hurt badly, not good that you got bruises. I know. Where are we going?
Back to the grocery store.
Your grandma wanted me to pick up some things for her.
That's good.
Dane? Rudy? They both smiled. They had almost the same smile. In fact, Jeanette realized they were also the same height, but their styles were different. Dane was wearing a crisp button-down shirt, khaki-colored and dark blue jeans. Rudy was wearing a chocolate-brown silky shirt with silver stitching and black buttons and simple but classic black trousers. Dane's warm toffee-brown hair didn't have gel or anything in it, but it didn't need anything to enhance his already shiny hair. Rudy had soft brown-black hair, a cool color in contrast to his pinkish complexion and barely there graham cracker crumb dipped in honey 5 o'clock shadow. It was longer on top, shorter near the back, combed to the side, and wavy but neat. While Dane's eyes were a bold, clear blue with black lashes complementing his slightly tan peaches and cream complexion, Rudy's eyes were mint and cream framed by dark brown lashes. Jeanette and Lucille had done each other's hair earlier in the day. And her normally straight, natural honey-colored hair was still curly, but Jeanette looked down at her own pink floral print shirt and hot pink jeans, feeling self-conscious. At least she had makeup on to cover her freckles, she realized. Rudy looked at Jeanette and held out his hand. I'm Jeanette. Dane and I are cousins. Well, nice to meet you. I'm Rudy. Let's exchange numbers. Hey. Jeanette, I thought you had left? I did. Then I came back, so I could talk to you. I just want to talk. All right. I want to tell you about your newfound cousin.
I'm listening.
I remember what it was like when Dane and I were your age.
How old?
Well, you're 17, right?
Well, here's what I remember. He was always kind. So kind, but being so kind, he never knows girls fell in love with him so easy. He was a good guy, but unbeknownst to him, he was breaking hearts constantly.
Why are you telling me this?
It's a matter of interest to you.
But you're still standing here, which proves my point. Being an outsider looking in, I want to tell you, I see the way you look at him, and I saw his reaction when you said you were cousins.
I've got the idea. If he isn't sure the two of you are related, but he wants to let you know that you might be related, I think he knows the likeliness of that, but the fact that he said it shows he saw it this time, that he pictured the possibility that you're not, and he's fighting it. But for him to even notice it, you got his attention.
Are you suggesting you know what I'm suggesting, or you wouldn't be blushing right now?
What do you have to gain from telling me?
I can help you get him. The plan is, even if you go in now, tell them you've been talking to your best friend and you're going over to that friend's house this weekend. That friend will pick you up. When the day comes, you'll know because Dane will have plans that day. He already told me. He even said he's leaving at noon. Then look for this car. I'll pick you up and I'll explain everything to you.
How do I know you're not going to abduct me?
And come out to the car and act like you're giving me directions and I'm lost and tell me your cell phone number. So then I'll explain it to you over the phone if you'd feel more comfortable with that. And the friend's house I'll be spending the whole day with?
Say your friend called you and wasn't feeling well if that's what you want to go with.
Or, I'll tell you my number right now, and if you call, explain everything. But I won't trust you if you're not specific with me. You'll have to be exact. Otherwise, I'm not approaching any cars driving up at noon or afternoon this weekend or the following weekends. I still don't see what you could get out of trying to help me with Dane.
Rudy nodded and pulled out the same notepad and pen as before. And surprised by his sudden seriousness and acquiescence to her idea, Jeanette gave him her number, and he left without a teasing remark or anything that could be taken as flirtation. Almost as if her authoritative tone put him in his place. Jeanette walked in, thinking about the conversation and puzzling over Rudy's intentions, forgetting to mention a friend she was supposed to have been talking to on the phone with outside just then.